Now, tell us about public enemy, one of the greatest groups of all time. What do you think was so special about public enemy? Because still today, lyrics, everything, it just resonates on so many different levels.
The brilliance of Chuck D is what's so special about public enemy, and also the teamwork, because public enemy was very much a team, and they had the Keith Shockley and Hank Shockley and Eric Sadler doing the production. They called them the bomb squad.
Right.
So what was amazing is that when you can take somebody who's college educated, a college graduate, who can still make the music sound like they didn't go to college, they just stayed in the hood and partied, you know, and make people feel the beats and the rhythms and use a language that people can understand and can still rock in the hood. I think that that's what is phenomenal. I think in this country, there's an expectation that if an African-born person in America goes into higher education and is successful, that there'll be a certain way. That there'll be an ass kisser, or there'll be somebody who assimilates, or somebody who can no longer relate to or never want to have a relationship with other African people. Well, I think Chuck D is somebody who defied that whole thing. He just took his intellectual, powerful mind and his incredibly powerful voice and lyrics and wrote songs that I believe will live forever.
But what do you think at the time when all of a sudden radio stations and others refused to play Public Enemy's music because they view it as too political, even though there's all types of political music out there, and basically it just bypassed everything. The public, as soon as they heard it, they wanted more and more and more.
The system is usually late.
Mm-hmm.
You know, it's just like, you know, when I wrote The Coldest Winter Ever, teachers didn't assign that book, but they should have. So the students read the book. The teachers had to catch up with the students. There were students writing to me telling me they're getting detention for reading my books in class. And my question was, how do you get detention for reading in school? Right? So it took some of the Board of Education's quite a long time to figure out that Catcher in the Rye is not the optimal novel for the African American, Latino, or Asian community. It's not. It took the literary community to figure out that Midnight, a Gangster Love Story is better than Shakespeare. It took them a long time to figure that out. Read it.
Preach.
Read it. Read it. And I think that for African people, because a lot of us are taught to dislike ourselves and to aspire to be someone else, we don't feel bold enough to say when we don't like something, or if you play a song and if mainstream America thinks that that song is the hot song, but African people or Latino people might not think that that's the hot song, but might not say that. But from when I was young, even when I was studying abroad in Europe and they took us to the Louvre and we saw the artwork, I could stand there in the corridor and be like, that shit is ugly. That doesn't look nice. So you're saying this is what all the hype is about? I don't know, she's some fat, pale, white lady with little twink lips and she looks awful. You know, why are we celebrating this? So, you know.